Today we are going to test Ethereum mining with T-Rex Miner version 0.26.5 and compare the results to 0.26.4. Oh, well, no, that is wrong. I never tested that version. We are going to test it and compare it to... there it is. 0.26.1. Oh, it's going to be very exciting. Sometimes sneaky performance boosts are included and sometimes the opposite. Let's hope that it actually gets better or stays at the same as a very minimum. Hello, my fellow Ethereum mining crypto miner. My name is Crypto Donkey Miner, and this is Bambi. Help save Bambi by clicking like and subscribing. If you don't, I will end up eating her. I'm not entirely sure how, as I have no idea how to cook her. It will most likely be some kind of microwave experiment, as I am super lazy today. Nonetheless, your fault if you don't like and subscribe. Isn't she cute and tasty? Changelog. T-Rex Miner 0.26.5. Make LHR unlocker compatible with older drivers, e.g. 470+ on Linux. Bug fixes. Ethash. Miner allocates excessive amounts of GPU memory, which causes 6 GB cards to stop mining on Windows earlier than expected. So exciting stuff if you use Windows, I guess, and if you want to use old drivers in HiveOS. Okay, it's not that exciting, but we are going to test it anyway. Ethereum overclock settings. Here you can see the overclock settings for the RTX 3050, RTX 3060, RTX 3060 Ti Hynix Revision 1, RTX 3060 Ti Hynix Revision 2, RTX 3070, RTX 3070 Ti, RTX 3080 10 gigs, and RTX 3080 12 gigs. All of them are using locked core clock. If you disagree with these overclock settings or you have some that are better, feel free to share them in the comment and of course include all the details like core clock, memory, etc. Thank you very much. Or send them with smoke signals. That will work too. Results. But first, if you're interested in learning C#, you can check out my new channel, DonkeySharp, where I am going through C# for beginners and will move on to Unity game making. Here we have the fantastic Ethereum mining hash rate for T-Rex 0.26.5. As usual, the RTX 3050 is absolute dominating, while the RTX 3070 sucks, especially when it comes to efficiency. To absolutely no one's surprise, the RTX 3050 is just superior even to the RTX 3080. And with that, take that, you stinky RTX 3070. In all seriousness though, only the RTX 3060 Ti results seem to ring a bell, so let's compare the results. The top is T-Rex 0.26.5 and the lower part is 0.26.1. The only noteworthy difference here is the RTX 3050, where .1 didn't have LHR unlock. We also see RTX 3060 draw one less watt, which could be coincidence, I guess. Especially considering the RTX 3060 Ti drawing one more. Now let's compare the high-end cards. Wow, huge difference is absolutely nowhere to be seen, with the exception of the RTX 3080 12 GB, which again was before LHR unlock. Usually when there's anything to detect, my RTX 3070 Ti would happily do it. It actually fluctuates quite a bit sometimes when I change versions, but well, not in this case, and that is most likely because there's absolutely nothing to be gained. Did I just say nothing or nothing? Ah, maybe I've turned into a German. Anyway, let's move on. There is nothing to see here. I am, of course, joking. Well, the Danish accent sucks a lot more than the German-English accent, so congrats on that, my German friends. Now go build some nuclear power plants so we can have cheap power in the European Union again. Thank you very much. All your gas are belong to us. Mining screen. Ah, the fantastic mining screen. If you're wondering which NVIDIA driver I was using, NVIDIA 510.68.02. Why didn't I use one of the 470+? Well, I can't because I have the RTX 3050 and RTX 3080 12 gigs. Insert sad panda face for maximum dramatic effect. Well, all panda faces are sad. So the RTX 3050 doesn't only completely dominate the hash rates and efficiency, it also dominates the driver choice. Very lovely graphic card. I love it. It's the best ever. That is all for this time. I hope to see you in the next one. Like, subscribe.